Are you having the almonds soaked in water daily every morning? What? Giddy again? Everybody around is falling sick. Just go for a checkup and ensure that you do not go alone. Be careful while you cook something and please, please doubly check that you have the gas knob turned off. Do you even know how to cook? Do not order too many times from the outside. Walk down to the grocery store and purchase vegetables. You can manage to cook once in a while. Save money. You haven't called Dad in 2 days. He's worried. Have you blocked each of us on Facebook? Because I don't see any more new posts coming from you. Say hello to these familiar set of drum rolls your best partners in the world comes with. Moms. Oh, what a mess. You feel like breaking up all the time. And you do. But unlike all the other breakups wherein you have sleeved up with shields of ego clashes, no understanding, daggers wounding damage to self-respect and dignity, and you are swearing on your respective mothers to never, never get back to them ever again. This is always a sheltered home. Moms, our morning school or afternoon schedule, extra classes or weekend rehearsals, there wouldn't ever be one single meal missed. The instructions won't stop. The emotional blackmail of securing either the top 3 rank in class or no ice cream for a month was a constant. Science often fails before the mommy logic. If one paper for the board exams went well, that entire meal which was prepared on that very day would be repeated for all the other papers because who knows, paratha and sarso wali bhindi could be a lucky charm. That being the same women who'd often vocally proclaim that people are just following these useless religious gurus owing to their superstition, and look where the world is leading to this 21st century. My competition days used to be really rough because of my performance anxiety. And so all my assurance queries of Ma, I'm winning this, right? Were met with, you just got the hard work in your hand and the results do not really matter. It would often annoy me thinking that it actually didn't matter until some time back I was told she's getting all the certificates framed to be decorated across our hallway and her bedroom. World sings of the special stories about how fathers have a better bond with daughters and moms with their sons. We are 2 sisters and therefore it's really, really difficult to tell at times. What I do know is that she's the only one who could fit in all brackets we create as children. Her every 1 hour phone call when you're away might appear imposing in the beginning, but the first breath you take whenever you speak to her, and she knows you got a cold or you are dull or you're cornered or just not liking the city anymore. Between the first crush in the school to the best friend at work, Ma has always known beforehand which of your relationships are forever, even more so the ones which are going to crumble. We really are looking for that companionship everywhere around us wherein we have the liberty to return to her at any point we want, in any manner we would like. Maybe to take out Dad's frustration on her because obviously you cannot counter speak before him. To tell her that you are least interested in marriage. To break down before her about a failing marriage. To click a selfie with her about a Mother's Day post. Or to instruct her to not ask you too many questions. Oh, isn't she cool? She follows us all in every manner possible. You could be the richest man alive and she would still ask you to not overspend on clothes or perfumes. You could be the hottest woman with the hottest body and you shall still get to hear from her, you are too skinny. That's not how you live. Eat more. Between her and you, she really is the sun that's only meant to bring you shine and not burn. So the next time you're tempted to end your life, basis this love at first sight which did not work out for you, do remember that she has loved you ever since much before you were even brought to this world. And I know we don't say it enough, but we got to be doing it more often. Go to them, hold their hands and telling them, hey partner, I'm never going to break up with you ever again. As about my family, did I tell you about my over-filmy, over-dramatic parents owing to the literature background of my father and the psychology background of my mom? Among other things, my mother loves scrutinizing all the new people in my life, especially the new faces in my phone's gallery. As luck would have it, I'm seeing her hopefully before 24 hours next. And well, when we meet, the first 15 minutes will be spent on how my hair coloring makes my hair worse than a broom she would use my house for cleaning, or how she hates my big glasses or doesn't like the color of my lipstick, or why am I not wearing gloves or glasses or socks given it's too cold. And I know that exact point when she's going to stop with a picture in my phone gallery and her over-suspicious, murderous, mysterious look only through her eyes to say, "Who is he?" And I think I've been nervous and really excited and rehearsing about this. I'm going to be smiling, looking down, looking back up again and say, "Ma, both him and I like that part of the Bangalore city where the roads converge and it appears like the trees are converging too. December is not too bad for a new beginning, isn't it?" That's about it. Thank you.